Good morning. It is nice and early. It's about 7 o'clock and I'm just going for a run. I thought I would tie in my morning run with possibly sunrise up at Sacré Coeur, because our hotel is like literally just one street away. But it might be quite nice to get up there and see if there's a nice sunrise, although I don't think there probably will be with the weather. If you watched yesterday's vlog and you saw us walking up these steps to Sacré Coeur, you probably couldn't see because it was so dark, like really how many steps there are. But the daylight, look at that. So many steps. The urge to destroy is a creative urge. This is by far the best time to visit. There's literally like 10 people around. There's not going to be much of a sunrise, but it's just nice to be here in the peace and quiet. Look, just there behind me. So nice.
I'm looking outside my window. I try to see where my luck goes. I just don't know how it slips out. There must be some kind of plan.
Stephen's finally up, so we're just gonna nip downstairs, get our breakfast, and then we're gonna head out. It is, what time is it? 9:20. We're just getting our metro tickets. Yeah, and you're 11. Our first stop is Arc de Triomphe. That's what Stephen wanted to do in Paris. Oh, scared me. Oh, there we are. I think it's raining.
Yeah.
To get to the Arc de Triomphe, it's in the middle of a big roundabout, so you've got to walk underneath the subway. So we're just walking under the subway now, and we're going to head up. Stephen wants to go up to the top of it. We've done it before, but he wants to go in. I think we're going to get, the good thing in Paris is if you're under 18, actually no, I think if you, I don't know what, under 18 there, Stephen's free for most museums and things. I think I'm going to get like a museum pass, it's a 2-day museum pass. I think it's like 48 euros, but I think it's probably be worth it for the things that we're going to be doing.
I got my little museum pass for 2 days, yeah, 48 euros that cost.
Oh, here we go. Now we're in the centre of the roundabout with the Arc de Triomphe. I keep slamming doors. Well, so you can actually just come into this middle bit where the Arc de Triomphe is without a ticket, but then to go in and up, that's where you need your tickets. I forgot about all these spiral stairs up to the top. This spiral staircase up here is knackering, and also there's no good for my fear of heights. Oh my goodness, we didn't count, did we? We're knackered. Oh yeah, there's a spiral in each of the things. A spiral staircase at the top, there's a screen, there's a view from like right in the middle at the bottom. Oh yeah. So when you come up the spiral staircase inside, there's like a little exhibition type thing, which Stephen is just not interested in. He just wants to get up to the top. Look, there's a model of it and different things. We got a few more steps and then we're at the top. I hope it's not raining. Is it raining? Oh, here we are at the top. Views over Paris.
Every person could be you though. A pretty guy with a halo. But who am I kidding? Please now. I gotta realize that
it's started raining. It is not a very nice Parisian day, unfortunately. The views from here are pretty amazing.
Down all the stairs, I'm petrified. This is just no good for me whatsoever. I hate it.
I literally walk along like clinging this wall, like not going into the centre there. I hate it so much.
She's so scared. Yep, it is pissing down out here. Well, this is where the camera was before, wasn't it? When I showed you that screen, the camera is just like right in the middle up there, and it was taking shots of all this. Wave to everyone.
This is the eternal flame. It's always lit to commemorate the people that died in the First World War.
You know when we were in that chocolate factory? We took a picture of the chocolate Arc de Triomphe because it had the names on. These are, I'm assuming, people from the First World War that died. We took a picture to see because obviously they've got the names here. But they've done it wrong. We've just checked each side. Some of the names on here are where they say they are. But most of them are not. The French people. I don't think... No, it's, yeah, maybe.
To understand what we could do around the world, say to Peru. We lie in bed till it's p.m. Eating breakfast when it's dark again. Let us be partners in crime. You and me as body and blood. We'll dance along in the afterglow.
This is the Champs-Élysées. We were going to walk down it, but due to the rain, changed our mind. We're going to get the metro. Yeah? Look, the weather is horrible.
Very silly.
we're not going there, but this is the Grand Palace. Look, it's even more spectacular from this side. I have no idea why we thought Paris in, well, it's not February anymore, is it? It's March, 1st of March. But yeah, why we thought Paris on the 1st of March was a good idea. It's cold and wet and miserable, but never mind. We are going, we're going inside, we're going to go museum day for the rest of the day, I think. We're going to, I have no idea how you pronounce this, but the history museum in Val, I'm gonna call it how you say it. Like, you would pronounce it like invalids in English, but it's not called that, I'm pretty sure. That's not how you pronounce it in French, but that's where we're going. And this bridge that we have to cross, there's rain falling on my camera. This bridge we have to cross, I was reading a blog and they said that it's a really pretty bit, really pretty bridge, and you get some good views of the Eiffel Tower. So I put it down on one of my things to see, and it, by accident, it just so happens to be the bridge that we have to cross to get to the place that we're going, invalids. That's what I'm gonna call it. But that's what it is there, the place with the gold.
I don't wanna go there.
You don't wanna go there?
There.
Look at this bridge. There's water on my lens. You'll just have to excuse that. It's a pretty cool bridge. This is really not what you want when you want a little sightseeing tour. It is honestly. We're freezing, it's cold, it's windy, it's like the worst. Oh crap, there's water in the puddle. It's like literally the worst weather it could possibly be. Oh my goodness. And well, we haven't come with coats and things because, well, we're hoping that we go warmer places. Oh my goodness, it's terrible, but we're nearly there now, look. It's just up ahead where we're going. This is how bad Stephen's feeling about the situation. He's given up on it all.
No.
Oh. Right, okay. I thought you'd like. I thought you'd just given up. He said his socks are wet, the poor thing.
Oh.
Oh no. So this place is part of our little museum pass that we can get in for free. So this way. This is like the central courtyard. I feel like we've been here before. We haven't? Should we get in underneath? Look, that museum, arm museum over here. Got all those cannons?
Look who it is.
Who?
In the middle.
Who is it? Oh, Napoleon?
Yeah.
Is it Napoleon?
Yeah. Let me zoom in for you. Museum, so. This guy.
Oh, thank goodness, there's like a little undercover walkway all around the courtyard, so we can stay dry. Well, stay dry, we're soaking wet, but we could not get any wetter. Okay, we just tried to get in and we couldn't. Little tip, if you have one of these and like you've got your kids for free, you still need to get a free kids ticket for some reason. The woman was kind of saying that they do counts on how many people come and stuff, so you've got to get a ticket. You can't just go into like a thing and, yeah, you need a ticket for kids.
Mark it down.
I know.
Okay, we're inside the Army Museum. Oh, look at these. Why did they like make them fancy? I don't understand that. What was the point? Well, look at this one with the like the man on top.
The amount that Stephen knows about like the war and weapons and stuff, he's just been explaining to me about what was it called? About crossbows and things. He knows quite a lot. I don't know where he's got his information from. Games, from video games, there you go. Video games is not all a waste of time. Oh, show me something over here.
Guns.
Oh, I think I've done 10,000 steps.
Oh, is that for like
a kid?
A kid? Or small people? Oh, yeah, armour pour enfant. Like my French accent. Child armour. They didn't have to fight though, did they? Or did they? That's like, do you think that would fit you?
No.
Do you think it's someone smaller than you? Someone younger than you would have to fight?
No.
Oh my goodness. Look at this thing, it's like three. What's that called? What number is that? It's just a pistol.
Triple barreled wheelback pistol.
There's one thing that's guaranteed to keep Stephen happy. Bring him to an army weapon museum. And he's good. Whoa, what are these?
Whoa.
Samurai armor.
We have a plan that we think that they should turn this bit here into like a little joke bit. This guy there, he is scary as hell. And we think that they should put a real person in there. And then like people are just like standing there watching, like looking at the armour. And then he just like picks up his spear and like goes to throw it at you or something. Do you think? That would just freak me out. Yeah. No. Oh, well, this goes on for ages, isn't there? So many, like, things. Whoa, what are they? Spears? This is definitely more of a Stephen place than a Meese place.
That's what they used to have bones.
He's taking pictures of all these weapons and things to show Jake. His cousin. Is it for Jake?
Yeah.
To show Jake. Check this bottom one out. Like, how was that? Yeah, but how was it even used then?
You put it in a trench.
Oh, of course. Yeah, and you rest it. But why does it need to be so long? What's the point? Anyone who understands weapons, tell me why this needs to be so long. Please. Like, how does that make it shoot further?
Makes it straighter for longer.
I found my favourite sword. This one. How cool is that handle? I like that. That would be my sword. I found my favourite helmet as well. That one.
That's cool.
Yeah, you could. You've got little eye holes. tiny.
This is awesome. Japanese. Oh, whoa. Look at that.
Dragon.
I was going to say, did they fight on dragons? I don't know why I was going to say that. I know. Whoa, this is Chinese. You can have my phone. European. This won't be as exciting. This isn't. Oh yeah. Look at these teeny little things. Do they actually work in things,
yeah.
Or they? Yeah.
Yeah.
Did they use like with bullets? Like they would use them. Whoa. They're like the size of my finger.
Not even that.
Not even that. They're smaller. Yeah, they're smaller than my finger. I think I might have changed my favourite mask to this one. Oh no, this
one. He's got a nose.
I like him. I like the way he's got eyebrows.
Not eyebrows,
that's
funny, looks out.
Yeah, but they look like eyebrows because he's got holes. Okay, we're done in that little section of the museum. Stephen wants to now go to the World War One and Two. What? Cannons? No. It's just World War One and World War Two part of the museum. Ooh, it's upstairs to this bit. Whoa. This is really cool. You can kind of see like the battle plans and how the movement was around France and
this
Germany.
This is the Allied offensive.
It's pretty cool. Okay, we've done World War One. I think we're going into World War Two now. Yeah. I can see Hitler up ahead. So yeah. Yeah. I think we are finished in the Army Museum. Honestly, I think you can probably spend a lot longer. There's so much to see, isn't there? Because there's a few little bits that we haven't been to and stuff, and if you've got headsets and things. But yeah, we are
headsets
done.
Headsets take like 5 hours.
Yeah. Yeah. But I think the plan is still horrible, and I don't think it's raining. Maybe is it raining? No, I think it is.
I don't see it.
Yeah, it's still raining.
A tiny bit though. Just a tiny bit.
I think the plan now is, I've got a hair on my camera, sorry. The plan is to head over to Museum de Orsay, I think it's called. Stephen doesn't want to go. He's not interested at all in paintings. If you don't know, I studied art at, studied art. I did teaching at uni, but with art. And I studied art. Really like art, and there's some amazing paintings in that museum, and I've never been, so I'd like to go and see them. Obviously, like I said, it's not a Stephen type thing, but this is a Stephen thing and a not really me thing. So we're maybe just going to go there just quickly. It's not far from here, so it's like a one stop on the metro, and then I think we might head back to the hotel for a little bit and then come out later this evening. Look at these, we're about to get the train. There's double-decker trains, we love them, don't we?
Yeah.
We got our train, we're going upstairs. Oh, I don't know why this excites me, but it does slightly. Does it you?
Yeah.
Double-decker train. Oh,
we liked our little trip on that train. We only had to do one stop though. Stephen's a little bit annoyed that we only had one stop. Yeah, instead of sitting down, there's so many seats. Okay, we're here at the museum. There's not much of a queue, so that's not bad. Inside Museum d'Orsay. It used to be a train station. Can you tell?
Yeah.
Okay, so we want to go. I still need Cézanne a lot, and also we need to go up to Renoir, Monet, Cézanne, Degas, and then also they've got the Van Gogh. How much interest Stephen has, always run away, in an art museum. None whatsoever. Having fun? Did you like seeing those Van Gogh? No? Check out this view. Oh my goodness. Wow. This one, how nice is this one? This is the Tulips in Holland. This is by Monet. I've never seen that one before. So nice. I'd love to go and see those tulips as well. Love this one by Renoir as well. Done in here. There are so many amazing paintings and sculptures in here. If you are an art lover, I would definitely recommend it. We're gonna head back to the hotel, I think, for a little bit now. We've been back in the hotel for an hour or so, and it is literally pissing down outside. So I think
these ones are just gonna get wet.
Are your shoes wet? Oh, Stephen's shoes are soaking from the floor. Yeah, literally pissing down, so we're not gonna, the plan was maybe to go into the centre a bit and like see the Eiffel Tower lit up and stuff, but I think that's not gonna happen. So we're just gonna nip out, just go and see the Moulin Rouge, because I've never been over sort of that side, and it's really close to the hotel. Oh, there you go, Moulin Rouge. We've literally come out and just gonna like visit it and go back again. I just wanted to kind of see it. It is not a nice evening at all. Look at everyone with their umbrellas in there. It's horrible, isn't it? Oh. Completely failed. There was two reasons that we came out. One, to just have a little look at the Moulin Rouge. And two, to buy a bottle of water and buy some like Sprite or something so Stephen can take some paracetamol. And I've only gone and left my flipping... I'm not in focus. I've only gone and left my flipping money at home because I was booking our flights for the next place we're going on Friday, and obviously I need my cards and stuff, and the money is on the bed, so that was a fail. Look, we're back. There's where I left my money, just right on the bed next to the passports after booking. I'm gonna nip out. Right, I'm gonna end it here because I'm just gonna nip out, buy a drink, and then we're just gonna chill out in the hotel. I'm gonna do some work and stuff for the rest of the evening. So thank you for watching today, and we'll see you tomorrow for some more fun in Paris. Good night. Say good night, Stephen.
Night.
Good night.